Hi, I'm Erica Villa. I'm professor of gastroenterology at the University of Modena in Reggio Emilia. I'm very happy to have the opportunity to present in our study enoxaparin prevents portal vein thrombosis and liver decompensation in patients with advanced cirrhosis, accepted for publication in gastroenterology. Thrombosis of the portal and mesenteric axis is a frequent event in cirrhotic patients with advanced disease. Its incidence ranges from 8 to 25% in different series and settings. There are several recognized risk factors, among them endoscopic treatment of esophageal varices and marked thrombocytopenia. Occurrence of portal vein thrombosis has several clinical implications, which may include worsening of hepatic function, development of resistant ascites, and above all, relevant technical issues during and after liver transplantation. The aim of our study was therefore to verify whether it was possible to prevent the development of portal vein thrombosis and to evaluate whether this was associated with improvement or liver condition. We thus compare in a prospective randomized trial low molecular weight heparin in a prophylactic dose versus no treatment. Primary endpoint was the prevention of portal or mesenteric vein thrombosis, while the secondary endpoints were the prevention of clinical decompensation, defined as onset of either ascites of hepatic encephalopathy or bleeding, and the improvement of survival. We enrolled patients with the cirrhosis of any etiology with a child puke score between B7 and C10, without evidence of portal or splenomesenteric thrombosis, free of ascites, hepatic encephalopathy, or active bleeding at the time of enrollment. Of 396 consecutive patients with cirrhosis we observed since 2008, 70 were eligible for randomization. 34 were assigned to enoxaparin treatment and 36 to no treatment. During follow-up, ultrasound was repeated every 12 weeks, CT scan at weeks 48 and 96, or whenever there was suspicion of portal vein thrombosis on ultrasound. During the year of active treatment, no patient in the enoxaparin group developed portal vein thrombosis compared to 6 of the control group. At year 2, none of the enoxaparin treated patients had yet developed portal vein thrombosis compared to 27.7% of controls. Both these differences were highly significant. Actual probability of developing portal vein thrombosis, as you can see in the slide, was lower in the enoxaparin treated group. Cox aggression analysis showed that enoxaparin treatment and a higher protein C level were independently associated with a decreased risk of developing portal vein thrombosis. Regarding the episode of liver decompensation, the difference between enoxaparin treated group and control was highly significant both during treatment and the follow-up and in the overall evaluation. Actual probability of developing the compensation, as you can see in the slide, was lower in enoxaparin treated patients than in controls. Cox aggression analysis showed that enoxaparin treatment, baseline bilirubin, portal vein diameter, and previous encephalopathy were independent risk factors for the compensation. 13 controls and 8 enoxaparin treated patients died. Causes of death were not significantly different in the two groups, with sepsis and progressive liver failure as the main causes. Kaplan-Meier survival curve revealed a higher survival rate in an enoxaparin treated group than in controls. Independent factors related to survival were enoxaparin treatment and portal vein diameter. As a compromise, intestinal mucosal barrier, as it is found in advanced cirrhosis, may lead to increased bacterial translocation and favor inappropriate activation of coagulation. We also evaluated intestinal fatty acid binding protein, a marker of enterocytic damage, and three markers associated with the microbial translocation and the immune response to it, bacterial DNA, soluble CD14, interleukin-6, to evaluate whether enoxaparin, by improving intestinal microcirculation, was able to decrease mucosal ischemia and reduce bacterial translocation. All marker studies were positively influenced by enoxaparin treatment. On the whole, enoxaparin treatment was very well tolerated. There were no significant side effects apart from thrombocytopenia in one patient that led to discontinuation of treatment. Bleeding episodes were few, two in each group, and of similar severity. The result of this randomized control trial in a cohort of patients with advanced liver disease showed that anticoagulant treatment with enoxaparin is safe if effective, is able to significantly reduce the risk of portal vein thrombosis development and that of liver decompensation, remarkably improved liver function and child puke score, and increased overall survival. In our view, portal vein thrombosis and decompensation are similar expression of a rapidly worsening portal hypertension. By damaging the intestinal mucosal barrier, severe portal hypertension leads to ischemic systemic dissemination of enteric bone infection, inappropriate activation of the coagulation system, and strong upregulation of systemic inflammation. Enoxaparin would act on microthrombosis, facilitating blood flow and improving endothelial function, and eventually decreasing bacterial translocation, preventing at the same time portal vein thrombosis and decompensation.